the hounds with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la. Join the chorus. Follow me in merry measure while I tell of you thy treasure.
Marley was dead to begin with. There is no doubt whatsoever about that. I mean, like, come on, guys, let's be honest. The register of his burial was signed by the clergyman, the clerk, and the heck that. This intro, dumb. We're ad-libbing this shiitake mushroom. Marley heckin' died, and everybody was really sad about it. I mean, look at their tears, like, oh. But none were quite as bummed as his bestie and fellow business partner, become a narrator, they said. You have the voice for it, they said. Well, Mom, look at me now. Look at what I have become. Look. The beans or Scrooge. See, Scrooge didn't like the Jesus all that much, so he did a lot of things to get as far away from him as possible. He was old as dirt, and he smelled like it too. Ooh, God the Chief.
Yes, quite dead, isn't he?
Well, yes, Mr. Scrooge. The poor fellow never saw that heart attack coming.
Of course, you'll need the necessary payments.
Pay?
Yes, sir. You'll need money for the funeral ceremony, you know, get him his own plot of land, prepare the ongoings for his friends and family, and of course, buy him a coffin.
Yes, and what good is that supposed to accomplish? Old Marley hasn't got friend or family for miles that'll shed a tear for him. And what's this about a coffin? Just throw him in a box and put him in the lake. Then he can at least be useful and give the fishies some dinner. What? What'd I say?
Well, Mr. Scrooge, thank you for your input, but I insist on the funeral payments. Don't you want your old partner, Marley, to have a good send-off, one last goodbye?
Yes, that ought to be an interesting conversation. Marley! Marley! If you can hear me, raise your hand!
Get it!
Stop yelling at me!
See? There's nothing to it. Dead with a capital D-E-D. Utter humbug! A not so good day to you, sir!
Now listen here. You better pay for your dead guy, you not nice person. Or else I have to use my powers of Jesus Jitsu.
Hey, partner, I'm, borrow your eye coins.
All right.
Can't waste money like that. It's bad business. As long as you actually get them. wish I could say it was nice knowing you, Marles.
What a big dumb meanie.
I know, right?
Ah!
Now, if you haven't picked it up by now, Scrooge wasn't a very good old Chico. He fed the ducks with burnt toast, ooh, that's rude, and tipped the waiter in Monopoly dollars? Jeez. The only thing worse than having to put up with him was having to put up with him as your boss. What if we turn on our only source of heat?
Pratchett, what did we talk about?
Merry frickin' Christmas, Uncle Scrooge! It's me, Fred! Maybe you didn't hear me, I'll just say it again louder. Merry freaking Christmas, Uncle! God, I just love Christmas so much.
Come closer, my dear nephew.
No, do not do that. Just don't do that. Don't. Nice try, Uncle. But I remember the last time we had a little Christmas get-together and you put a fork in my leg. Won't let that ruin my Christmas spirit, though. But God, why did I not see a doctor for it? Oh, I'm so bad.
Ready? Do me a favor.
You're not gonna stab me.
Just a little. Get out of my office! Take that disgusting Christmas spirit with you. It's all humbug.
Humbug? Oh, come on now, Uncle. I'm here to invite you to the greatest Christmas party, like, ever. We're gonna celebrate Jesus Day by bobbing for apples and playing some Uno and some, maybe some sequence and, you know, other various games and, you know, when the sun goes down, we're gonna dance all night to the greatest hits of, the greatest kids bop hits, my bad. Of 1860. You should come. So what do you say, Uncle, if you want to come to my Christmas party?
No.
Wait, did you say there's gonna be Uno?
Pratchett!
Why?
You know, it's a little chilly in here. I'll just,
That's heat up. He gets a little stingy with our only source of heat.
That was supposed to last us all of next year!
I'm so sorry, Uncle. You know what? Let me just give you your Christmas present early to make up for it, okay? I know that was your only source of heat, but this fire beat will keep your workplace warm for the rest of the year. I promise. 100% guarantee, okay? I hope this present can make up for me ruining your only source of heat. There you go. I love you, Uncle.
Get out!
I still love you, Uncle.
Oh, I think you're bringing down myself!
That was hurtful.
Humbug!
What are you doing that?
Oh, good evening, gentlemen.
Hello. It's a little bit chilly in here. You wanna turn up that thermostat?
Aye, let me just help you with that.
Take that fire and you won't be needing any warmth this Christmas.
Well, yeah, because the fire's on you, homie.
You got him! You must be Mr. Scrooge. I'm John. Nice to meet you.
Just tell me why you're here so that I might more swiftly deal with your sorry behind.
Well, me and my buddy over here, Bonobo, we're here to endorse prosperity and generosity this Christmas season.
Yeah, and then Mr. Scrooge, can you donate to the poor people so they can get blankets and clothes?
Oh, that's very nice of you two. Like, it's blessed be you guys. I mean, like, wow. Cratchit!
Oh, son of a gun, please, no. Oh.
Make that one a double.
Please, sir, even a little bit helps.
Well, are there no prisons? Union Workhouse is still in business.
Sadly, yes.
Treadmill still soldering on.
Oh.
Good. I was concerned I missed an act of mass arson.
So, how much can we put you down for then?
Nothing. Zilch. Nada.
Which one?
I will donate $0!
That's not fair.
But what about the sick and needy?
I say to you again, are there no prisons?
You mean,
I'm sure they have room for a few more for Christmas.
Many, many, many can't, sir, and they'd rather die.
If they would rather die, then they'd better do it and decrease the surplus population!
Hey, boss. I think I broke my chair.
Get some tape!
Hey, Mr. Scrooge, boss.
Bah.
I was just wondering, I mean, like, if there's a chance, possibly, I mean, that I could, like, maybe, like, just like a very slim chance, like, if there's any chance possible, you know, like, perhaps, if there's, like, like 50-50, even I take like 20.
For the love of God, man, save me the torture!
Can I please take Christmas Day off?
No.
Please, Bowser, please.
No.
Just one day, Bowser. I just want to spend it with my kids and my wife. My favorite people. And my wife.
Yes.
Really?
No.
You leave me no choice.
Christ, man, don't have an aneurysm.
Well, clearly, it states that in section 4, chapter 7...
All right! Fine! Consider your Christmas off, then. Just get that thing away from me! I'll have nightmares for days!
Right away, sir.
Fair hours. Equal wages. Of course. You'll be showing up by 3 in the morning the next day.
Of course, yes, yes, sir. Wait a minute.
You just got Scrooged, Cratchit.
Oh.
You know what to do.
You're lucky I pay you and your money, Cratchit, or you'd be broke. Speaking of which, it's payday.
There's gonna be a feast tonight, baby. Woohoo!
Have a terrible Christmas.
Like sawdust. Just the way I like it. Don't know what the frick that was, but I'm suing it.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
Now listen, I don't have much time, so I'm gonna kick it in real quick. I hope your life is going great, because mine sucks, okay? Cheap people have it rough in the afterlife, man. They can't buy any good Ferrari, man. I'm telling you, nothing, nada, big fat zero.
That's horrible!
They make us do all the hard work. We use, and we can't pay any.
That's double horrible!
We have to pay for each other. Poor people share everything.
That's triple horrible!
I know! That's why I'm here, Scrooge. You need to change your ways for the better. You need to start with the man in the mirror. Snow mirror here, Marley. Metaphor.
Start with the man in the mirror? What do... You mean being nice? Being nice? What do I have to be nice for?
That's why I'm talking to you. Let's face it, you're not a very nice person, man.
Scrooge, you say that as if I don't know that.
Listen, I hear you, but seriously, man, you need to chill the heck out. Listen, man, I hear you, but you have to be the change.
No.
I guess my work here is done. I can't help you, man, if you don't wanna be the change.
No.
Oh, I forgot to mention. You're probably gonna be visited by three ghosts today.
What?
You know, ghosts? Like me, but not jerks.
I'd rather be jerks, Marley, and I'm not a fan of ghosts.
That was hurtful. Well, I guess I tried. I mean, if I can't make you change your ways, I guess I'll leave it up to the powers of the undead to do it for me.
We don't have to do that.
The first of the three ghosts will arrive when the hands of the clock stretch out into the sky.
You mean midnight?
Midnight, 1, 3, 5. I forgot to write times down, to be quite honest. But those ghosts will do anything to teach you the real meaning of Christmas.
I would very much not like that.
Murder is a very strong possibility for you if you object. Yeah, very strong possibility.
Wait, Marley, let's talk about this.
Listen, man, I have to go back to my cheap brethren. Plus, I have a date with your
hot
ghost mom. Nice work. Alright, see you, Scroogey. Have fun. Oh, wait, I can't fly. Oh, God. Cheap people have it rough in the afterlife, man. They can't buy any good Ferrari, man. I'm telling you, nothing. Nada.
Oh, I forgot to mention.
You're probably gonna be visited by three ghosts.
Be the change. Want a Sprite cranberry?
I knew it! No ghosts! It was all humbug! Ha ha! Ah, God, my back! What the? Ah!
Come on, Scrooge, we've got a schedule to keep.
Who the heck are you?
How rude. Marley told you to expect me.
How do you know Marley?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Are you high? Ow! Am I high?
Come, Scrooge, we have places to be.
Now, just a minute! You may have broken into my house and played with my light switch, but you're not taking me anywhere, you spooky ghost, you! I'm not leaving this room!
You know, I can't breathe in this.
Of this place. That's my old school! I haven't been here in years!
This is a school?
Well, didn't have a very good program, so I mostly just sat on the rocks. Hey! That's your me!
You have red hair?
I had my reasons.
Silent night.
I was the best singer. And the best musician. Hey! That was my favorite song! Scrooge! My man! My bro! My brother! I haven't seen you in like 7 years! How are you doing?
I'm doing well.
That's so good. You know what's even better? Our dad is like a G now. He's so good. Like Christmas, good guy. Come on, let's go. Let's go spend Christmas with him. Yeah. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, come on, come on. Bro, come on, you idiot. Let's go.
Yeah, you see, I always loved my sister, but my dad hated me because I was mean. So she came over one time and she's like, hey, dad loves you now. So I just went over and...
Let's see how that turned out, shall we?
Oh. Hey! This is my old house! Building C! I loved this place until I was one and realized what my dad was saying. Oh! My neighbors! I guess they're dead now. Hey! Over here again! Hello! Oh, I can't see.
Dad, you said I could come home for Christmas, is that true?
Yes! And while you're here, you'll pay your rent, clean the house, file my taxes, and tell your mother I want a divorce. Oh, and prepare for the internship which we have paid for with your college fund. Said internship will take you far away where you will never see your family again. And reporters are prohibited and you have to dye your hair brown.
No! No!
Merry Christmas!
Oh yeah! My dad disowned me today.
Yeah, wasn't it great, Scrooge? Don't you just love Christmas?
No.
Let's go to the next scene.
Ah!
Isn't this exciting, Ebenezer?
You betcha, Richard.
Please, call me Dick.
Right. I can't wait for the celebratory speeches, the feast, the dancing.
I mean the girls, Ebenezer. If we're lucky, we might just find ourselves a Mrs. Wilkins and a Mrs. Scrooge.
Just hope they aren't the same person, huh?
I mean, I wouldn't complain.
That's kind of creepy, Dick.
I'm desperate, man.
He was always desperate for a woman, that Dick. Yeah, I'm not really seeing the point of this flashback experience, so, just head home or, ow.
Just keep watching.
What about it, Ebenezer? I've been seeing you, making moves, looking at her, it.
Dang, I thought I was being sneaky with it, too.
The dick sees all, Ebenezer. The dick sees all. Try communicating with her.
I wouldn't know what to say. The only woman I've ever talked to are my mom, my sister, and Miss Goodweather across the street.
Clear!
Scroogey, old pal. You and me could rule the city, or we could just fight to the death. But that's aside from the point. Who said anything about talking to it?
Oh, I got you.
And Wingman of the Year goes to me, your boy, Dick Wilkins.
I've always been a sucker for musicians. Play on, Ebenezer.
Alright, let's kick this party into high gear. Let's start that slow dance.
Do you, wanna dance?
You can go dance. I'm right here. Quite.
But you know, nobody used to dance quite like old Fezziwig.
What now?
This is fun.
What's that, Chief?
Hey, how you doing?
Oh, that's right. This was his last Christmas. What a way to go.
You see, Scrooge, this is what Christmas can be. Family, friends, fun, food, whatever that was. Love.
Love.
Love you almost had, Ebenezer.
No, I know what this is, Spirit. Bring me back. I want off. Do you hear me? Return. Cease. Ixnay on the Ashback Play.
Ebenezer, we have to talk.
Do we have to come outside? It's as cold as my heart out here.
Ebenezer, I'm calling off the wedding.
What?
I just can't take it anymore. You're greedy, you're cold, you're heartless.
I mean, yeah.
You weren't like this when we first met. But you've changed for the worse.
Yeah, I guess. But, Belle, do you realize how much money that'll waste?
What?
I've already paid for the wedding ceremonies. I've invested like $5. That's like a bazillion gumballs. Maybe I can resell this.
That was a pretty mean thing to do, Ebenezer.
She made me worse than I made her better.
She could have been your wife.
I'm already married to money. And also social Darwinism. What's the point in telling me this anyway? All it is humbug, humbug, and more humbug.
Let me take you someplace more recent.
Oh no, I've had just about enough of your somewhere, Spirit.
Off we go.
You better take me home to the place where I belong. London, England!
Ew. This isn't London. Or England. Or country roads. What, me Spirit?
No. Watch.
What the heck is Belle doing in a place like this?
She had to go somewhere after you left her, Ebenezer. She had to find someone else.
What are you...
Honey, dinner's ready.
Wait.
Good. I'm starving. I love your home-cooked meals, my wife.
Dick!
I am so ready for dinner, Belle.
You stole my wife!
But she was never your wife, Sue. You chose money, remember?
You! Richard!
I have the strangest feeling my name was just called out in English. I'm just good.
You are really starting to live up to your namesake!
Merry Christmas, Scrooge.
Now is not the time!
Man, I'm really happy I didn't marry that Scrooge.
Same here. Between you and me, I hate genders.
Hey! I dyed my hair, didn't I? Jerk!
The dick always wins.
Scrooge, wait.
We're done here. I'm going home. You're a terrible host. 0 stars.
But do you understand?
Understand what?
Understand the meaning of Christmas. The love, joy, happiness of the season. Giving, joining hands. Do you understand how terrible a person you have been? How greedy, selfish, stupid, annoying, dumb, and just, like, terrible.
I get it!
Will you change your ways, Scrooge?
Well, when you phrase it like that... No! Ha ha! You just got Scrooged! What the? Where's... Oh, God. My wrinkly old head. Yeesh, what a nightmare. But that's all it was. Just a bad dream. I'm sure I'll be back to my old self by morning. Let's hope I won't have to go through something like that again. Looks like I win this round. I'm only mildly delusional.
Alfred.
What are you doing in my house?
Loving humanity.
Dear God, you're a hippie.
No, Scrooge, I'm the living embodiment of happiness.
You're gonna have to be a bit more specific. I'm not fluent and joyful.
Everyone's fluent and joyful, Scrooge.
Try me.
Puppies.
Hate them.
Kittens.
I'm allergic.
Tom Hanks.
Turner and Hooch.
Oh my God, you are terrible.
Yes, sir.
Well, I'm gonna change that, old friend.
We're not friends.
But you will be after I give you a Christmas hug.
No, no! Bad oxytocin! No!
I'm gonna hug you someday, Scrooge.
I'm going to murder you.
Fine. Then I'll just have to take you on a magical journey.
magical journey. Stand.
To the tax return office?
No! We're going to your nephew friends.
No! Come on, the bag over my head again!
Merry Christmas, Scrooge.
Next I assume you'll be hitting me over the head with a book. What the heck is this?
It's a party, Scrooge.
There's nobody here.
Well, I mean, yeah, no one goes to a party early. But Fred's having a good time. I mean, look at him go. Oh my gosh, it's like Michael Jackson. He can't see us. Well, tell you what. What if we come back later? And we'll see how poppin' his party gets. When more people show up. You know what I mean.
Guess I don't have much of a say in the matter, do I?
No, you don't.
I hate him.
Where are we? Wait and see, Scrooge. It's a surprise.
I'll kill you. Smells like happiness in here.
Recognize that woman, Scrooge?
Is she my mailwoman?
No.
A cousin?
No.
Paula Dean?
She's your partner's wife, Scrooge. Emily Cratchit.
Wait. Cratchit is married? But he's so not likable.
Maybe to you, Scrooge, but during the holidays, Bob Cratchit is one of the most famous people, and quite popular, in this neighborhood.
I just thought he lived under a bridge somewhere.
Terrible day at work, as per usual.
Oh, that's nice.
God, I love you, Tiny Tim.
I love him as well.
Ah, classic Tim for ya.
Oh, what a talkative young boy.
Hey, why is Cratchit talking to a bulldog?
A dog?
Yes, that rather large bulldog right over there.
There isn't a dog in the room, Scrooge.
Yes, there is. Right there. Look, he's wearing a little hat.
Are you calling Tiny Tim a dog? That is not funny, Scrooge.
I'm not joking!
Honey, that smells delicious. What's for dinner?
Oh, it's just some Christmas pudding.
Ooh, ooh. Oh, God, I love our food.
Why is Mrs. Cratchit treating pudding like genuine Christmas food?
Well, not everyone's a rich jerk, Scrooge.
That was uncalled for.
Ring-a-ding,
no!
Oh, look at them, they're so happy throwing pudding. This is what true family is, Scrooge. Not that you would know. Your father hated you.
It's a wonderful Christmas. You might even have money to buy a main course this year.
Oh, that would be spectacular. After all, we are dying slowly from hunger.
Isn't everyone?
No!
But,
isn't it true?
I'm feeling slightly depressed.
Well, you want to feel even more depressed?
No!
Oh, look at that adorable little Tiny Tim right there. Let's just say, 1 year from now, that bed is gonna be, open, if you know what I mean.
God, that was awful.
Hey, you can't see us, we're ghosts. Found a cadaver, idiot.
It's awful! Please, Spirit, isn't there any way Tiny Tim can be saved?
Why should we save him? He He's gonna die, shouldn't he? Better do it. Decrease the surplus population.
Oh my god, that's that thing that I said.
It is.
Frick.
Call that dramatic irony, Charles Dickens style.
Should we go to bed, honey? We can't eat anything else because we can't afford anything.
Ah, I see. Come on, minuscule Timothy.
Stay here. I like it when you're here.
What did I say? We're going to bed. Come on, let's go.
Carry you again?
No?
Good. Let's go.
That's a good boy right there.
What a cutie.
It really is. Wait, he can't hear.
I feel so... I don't know!
Tell you what, bud. Let's head on back to Freddy Boy's party and see how poppin' it's gotten, you know what I mean?
Guess I don't have much choice in the matter, seeing as you're gonna put the bag over my head.
Where's my wand?
This is a party, Scrooge! Ew! This is my jam! Frick yeah!
What a great party, Fred!
Frick yeah!
Frederick, when are we gonna start these party games?
Soon as Uncle Scrooge gets here. What?
Honey, you do realize that Scrooge is not gonna show up, right?
What do you mean? I invited him. I even gave him that Kids Bop CD.
He's not a very nice guy, Fred.
He's actually quite a dingus.
What? But I invited him.
You know by now he's probably burned that Kids Bop CD.
This is why no one likes you, Miss Goodweather.
Aw, that's what my husband used to say. But then he died.
I'm out.
Well, you know, we can play some games now, but we can't have too much fun.
Yeah, I was gonna come back, but... no deal.
It's okay. He'll be back. I locked all the exits. You see, Scrooge? Your nephew still has faith in you. It wouldn't hurt you to give him a chance. But he's just so... aggravating! Maybe if you got to know him, he wouldn't be so aggravating. I know! How about we play, charades?
I hate charades!
What about Yahtzee?
The Lord frowns upon gambling, you sinner!
Who invited you?
There were invitations?
How can you see us?
I see all! Okay,
that's not supposed to happen.
Run!
That is... not how I was expecting that party to go.
Yeah, same here. Well, it was pretty fun, wasn't it, Scrooge?
Don't touch me.
Well, I'm running out of time, so let's head back to your place.
Running out of time? What do you mean? Huh. Finally, I escaped that weird party. More in store.
I hate Christmas.
Hey, this isn't my house.
Change of plans. Couldn't exactly make it back there.
You all right, bud? You don't look so hot.
Well, you know how I represent, like, Christmas joy and all that?
Yeah?
Well,
Christmas joy doesn't last all that long, so,
So what you're saying is...
I'm dying, Scrooge.
Yes!
Well, screw you too!
It's nothing personal, but I just can't stand how you continuously laugh all the time.
It's called happiness, Scrooge.
Eh, whatever.
Hoodlums! Oh, don't worry about it, Scrooge. They're just killing me.
Then why don't I like them?
Hey, it's an old guy.
Give me your wallet, old guy.
They're trying to take my money!
This is Boy Ignorance and Girl Want. They represent everything wrong with humanity.
Ah! Get them away from me!
Hey, you two. Scram.
Frick you, you wannabe Santa.
Ah, oh, bird.
She got you there, Scrooge. Where are they going?
To commit mass arson, I don't know. Oh, and Scrooge, it's been fun, like this whole awful time, but I've gotta get going.
You mean die?
Yes, I mean die! Be a bit more so, oh god. Spirit! Are you okay? Do you need a band-aid?
No, I'm dying, you idiot! But that's okay. It's kind of my time to go, and Scrooge, I have something to tell you.
What is it?
The next ghost. He's not like Pastor Eye. He's a killer, if you know what I mean.
I don't.
He's not all chuckles and baseball bats. He'll straight up just murder you. He will.
What do you mean?
He'll kill you.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
So, Scrooge, before I go.
Yeah, yes, what is it, Spirit? Please.
Come here.
Anything that
come,
you have.
Come closer.
Oh, yes. Oh.
Got him.
Scrooge's log, number 572. I am running out of ways to express verbally my own misfortune. I'm stranded in the middle of nowhere, and the second ghost is dead. Big surprise. Now I have to make my own way home. Again, big surprise. All I've got is a name, it's a lantern.
Kaka!
A couple of dumb birds. Stranded in the middle of nowhere with no habitable life in sight but a couple of dumb birds. Just my luck. Just my luck. This is how Scrooge died. Stop. Nowhere. No one. Don't shoot. Yes, they're dying of carbon monoxide poisoning. I didn't make any
funny. It's not breaking and entering if it's Christmas.
Sorry about bringing into your house and junk.
How much for the curtains?
$7.
It's a little pricey, don't you think?
I'll throw in a kiss.
I'll pay $14 if you don't.
Is that Miss Dilber?
You're supposed to be cleaning my house right now, you lousy maid! Get back to work! Ow!
Hello, Satan. I've been expecting you. You're not Satan? Are you the Grim Reaper? Perhaps I've been looking for him, too. Oh, you're one of those spirit things! So this is all the future, then? With Joe and Miss Dilmer? Neat.
So how did you get all this fabric anyways? Wouldn't the government have snagged it?
I'm his maid, Joe. I snuck in, grabbed what I could, and took it.
Yeah, I guess he deserved it.
Yeah, not even I would have kissed him.
Please, don't talk about that.
Dying in the sleep, apparently. Alone.
Just like you're going to.
I mean, you're probably right.
You and the curtains.
Hey! Are those my curtains? What the heck is going on here? This is my room! Why are the lights off? Is that my chair? Is someone sleeping in my chair, Spirit? Is someone dead? Is that person dead? Is someone dying in my chair? What is this? Hey! Is that Bob Cratchit? Did Bob Cratchit come over here and die in my chair? What? Spirit? Where am I?
Sorry for your loss, old buddy. He was a jerk anyways.
Oh, the biggest jerk. True. Jerk. Like beef jerky. Except without the beef, without the jerky, and extra jerky.
You know, I'm starting to think he really wasn't that cool of a dude.
How long did it take to figure that one out?
Well, we had these Christmas parties every year, and he never even showed up to them. And those parties were frickin' poppin'.
How popping are we talking?
We may or may not have murdered Miss Goodweather last year.
Dude, that's frickin' poppin'.
Spirit! I know you can hear me! What's the point in bringing me here? I already knew Fred's parties could be popping. What's the point in showing me this? Bring me home! What the flim-flam?
Wait a minute. Spirit, is this a graveyard?
Ah, Tiny Tim. He always was the goodest boy.
Yes, he was a good boy, but now he's dead.
Ah, indeed. Now he is dead.
Yes, now he is dead.
I will never forget his final words. Borg! Borf! Borf!
Yes, those were his final words, but now he is dead. I'm gonna go put dinner on the stove.
Ah, you always were my favorite dog. I mean son. You always were my favorite son. I salute you. Thank you for saving us this extra food.
God, that son of a gun, Scrooge.
Wait a minute! Did little old Tiny Timbo go and die? Oh, heck no! Bring me back, Spirit! I don't want to feel all depressed and crud! You're not... What is that a rock? Is that...
just a poorly constructed gravestone? You want me to read it? Okay. Huh. Scroogey. Who's that?
Says Scrooge, you blistering idiot.
Oh. Is that my sister?
No, it's you. You died and everyone is happy. You have no friends. Everyone hates you.
Oh.
No!
One more thing, Ebenezer. You just got Scrooged!
Who are you?
Boy, poor chap. Never learned how to walk. Ah, it is a shame.
Cover up. It's cold out.
Please! I'll change!
I'll change!
Mr. Stilber! Are you alright, sir?
Mr. Stilber! You're not pawning off my curtains for pocket change!
No, sir. Not yet, at least.
Hold that thought! You there! Small child!
I am 7.
What day is it today?
Why, it's Jesus Day, of course. What are you, an idiot?
It's still Christmas! There's still time! Listen, boy.
$12?
This is 3 months' allowance! Take that money and buy the biggest turkey you can find!
I'm 7. How am I supposed to carry a turkey?
Once you get the turkey, bring it straight to Bob Cratchit's house by noon!
Who's Bob Cratchit?
Merry Christmas!
I wonder if GameStop is still open.
It's Christmas! It's Christmas!
Wow, really? I have no idea. I still have to work on Christmas, you know?
I'm too excited to be frazzled by a backstabbing woman! Oh, Dilbert, I could kiss you!
I'll pay you 14 if you don't do that.
You know, Dilbert, take the rest of the day off!
What?
Go be with your friends and family! It's Christmas!
What have you done with the boss that I hate?
I've seen the light, Dilbert! I've seen the light!
Must have had a heart attack. Heck if I care. Ooh. These are some nice curtains.
You two! Get out of here, you punk!
Haven't you robbed from the children enough?
Here is a check for $12,000! But why? I hope that'll be enough to help all the sick and needy.
Merry Christmas.
Goodbye.
I think he finally snapped.
Like a toothpick.
$15,000 in 1843. That's a lot of money.
Yeah, he could have just put himself in crippling debt.
Is it time to skip away?
You know it.
is the best party ever!
Yeah, it's pretty jamming!
I've seen better.
Why, thank you!
There's only one thing that could make this any better. No way! No how! Did somebody order a kids' bop?
I think he's dead.
Yeah.
You brought the greatest hits, the greatest kids' bop hits of 1860, and killed Mrs. Goodweather? This is the best Christmas ever! It's a Christmas miracle! You're the best, Uncle Scrooge! I love you, Uncle Scrooge! No more
oxytocin! This is the school! Tiny Tim must be here! Tiny Tim! Tiny Tim!
9 o'clock.
Physics.
I'm looking for Tiny Tim!
I don't think you can just come in here.
Okay, thanks!
Sharpen your pencils, kids. This isn't a drill.
I'm looking for a Tiny Tim!
I don't know who Tim is, but I love your energy!
Alright, thanks!
Who the heck was that?
I don't know, but I sure liked his hat.
I didn't.
What did they even have at school on Christmas?
Hi, I'm Madison Red Pie!
Hi, I'm Madison Red Pie. What
are you doing? Oh, I'm so sorry.
Excuse me, do you know who I am?
Paula Dean.
No. I'm the mainframe gamer.
Oh. Nice to meet you, Mr. Mainframe.
I don't do handshakes.
Homeschooled.
What? Oh.
I'm Jerry Shelton. This is my world.
I'm Ebenezer Scrooge!
Yeah? Get out of my classroom. Wait a minute. You don't play tuba, do you?
Merry Christmas, honey.
Are you sure we should eat this much, Bob? Maybe we should have smaller rations.
Okay, if we can't eat one more piece of cereal than normal on Christmas, why are we even celebrating? Cheers.
Merry Christmas, Tiny Tim! Ah!
Was that your boss?
Heck.
Boss, I'm sorry I'm 30 seconds late.
Cratchit!
Yeah?
I am very upset!
Listen, were you the guy who, threw the chocolate pudding at me and my wife yesterday morning?
Certainly not! Don't change the subject!
Yes, sir.
Cratchit, you are exactly 30 seconds late! 30 seconds nonetheless!
But Bob,
I am getting tired of your shenaniganery! Consider yourself fine!
Mouse, you Gucci, my guy?
Fire! Freaking fire! Fire from being poor!
Mouse. Calm down, Mouse. Mouse, you need a doctor?
Only if your doctor is fluent in Christmas cheer! Am I right, Ghost of Christmas Present? Oh, that's right, he's dead.
Mouse, what's happening?
Cratchit! Have all your money back! And consider yourself promoted with triple salary!
I overdid it a little.
Cratchit, I'm not joking around. I'm serious. Your salary has increased, and you've considered yourself promoted. And I swear to you, I am going to do my best to support you and your little old son until all good old Tiny Tim gets all unsickified. Now, breathe slowly into this red paper bag. Not use the happiness! 2 bucks oxytocin! Ah!
And there you have it. An old Scrooge was better than his word. He donated to the poor, housed the homeless, and became the best man the city had ever known. And Tiny Tim, who did not die, came to view Scrooge like a second father. Many people still talk about Scrooge's amazing sudden change, but none could quite figure out what caused it. One thing was certain, however, it was the best Hanukkah Tiny Tim had ever witnessed.
He said, God bless us, everyone. Now come on, Tim, you gotta get on my back. Come on, Tim. Come on, Timbo.
I'll get on your back, Uncle.
Thank you.
lights. 3, 2.
Damn, this is coming.